I hope all of you are fine at home. In today's tutorial of social science, we are going to start chapter 11, our natural resources. Children, before reading the chapter, let's understand what is the meaning of the term natural resources. Okay, the natural resources are naturally occurring materials that are useful for man, such as air, water, land, forest, oil, minerals, etc. Okay, let's start reading, children. Open your textbook, page number 77, chapter 11, our natural resources. Nature has given us water, air, soil, minerals, plants, animals, and so on. These are called gifts of nature. We use these gifts of nature to fulfill our daily needs. Early humans did not know how to use these gifts of nature. With time, they learned to convert these into useful things to satisfy their needs. It was then that these gifts of nature became valuable resources for them. For example, wind is a gift of nature. When humans learned to generate electricity from wind using windmills, wind became a resource for them. Resources and their types. All materials available in our environment which satisfy our needs are called resources. They are of two types. All natural things such as land, air, water, soil, minerals, forests, and animals are known as natural resources. Things made by humans using natural resources are called human-made resources. Buildings, roads, machines, and electricity are examples. Types of natural resources. Natural resources are of two types: exhaustible resources, inexhaustible resources. Exhaustible resources. Some natural resources such as metals, iron, copper, aluminium, and fuels, coal, petroleum, natural gas, are available in a limited quantity. Once we use up these resources, we cannot create any more of them. Such resources are called exhaustible resources. They are also called non-renewable resources. Coal is an important source of power. It is used to cook, heat, and to generate electricity. It is also used to run steam engines and factories. Our country has large reservoirs of coal. These reservoirs are, however, limited. Petroleum is known as black gold. It is refined to produce petrol and diesel. These are used as fuel in cars, buses, scooters, ships, and aeroplanes. The petroleum reservoirs are limited. They are also not available in every country. Inexhaustible resources. Some natural resources do not get exhausted. These are called inexhaustible resources. Solar energy, air, water, plants, and animals are a few examples. They can be renewed. So, these are called renewable resources. The energy of the sun is called solar energy. Plants make food using this energy. It is also used to light streets, cook, heat, water, and generate electricity. Air is an important natural resource. All living things need air to live. Wind is used to generate electricity. Water is needed for drinking, washing, cooking, growing crops, and many other purposes. Electricity generated from falling water is called hydroelectricity. Plants give us food to eat and oxygen to breathe. Almost all animals depend upon plants for food. Trees prevent soil erosion and give shelter to many animals. This is why plants are called green gold. Soil is needed to grow plants. Fertile soil is good for crops. Conservation. We must use natural resources very carefully so that they last long. For example, groundwater is a renewable natural resource. But if we take out more water from under the ground than what rain can add, our groundwater reservoirs will get exhausted. This will lead to water shortage. Here are some ways to conserve natural resources. We must not pollute air, water, and soil. We must plant more trees. We must not hunt wild animals. We must save electricity. We must develop other sources of energy. Children, here we completed the reading of chapter 11. Children, you have to note down all the hard words in your notebook I have underlined. In next video, I will explain the chapter, solve the exercises and question answers. Thank you children for listening and watching the video. Stay at home, stay safe. Bye.